Good morning. It's Sarah with Lung Cancer Foundation of America, and I'm here with Dean Hannon this morning. Good morning, Dean. How are you?
Good morning, I'm well.
What a beautiful day where you are. You're in Long Island.
Yes, right near Seacliff.
Wonderful. So, Dean, I really, really appreciate you having this conversation with me this morning. I know it's not been terribly long since you lost your brother, and everything that I'm learning about your brother, Alex, is testament to his personality and his force of personality and the type of people that he drew to him. I'd love to hear more about your brother.
Yeah, so Alex was born January 6, 1972. He was, from the start, a very commanding presence. I personally think that when that day came, the world got even better and brighter. He was my older brother, and he was relied upon a lot for my parents, who were working parents, so he was always naturally a leader. He took on that role very well. He was always very positive. He was always a hard worker. He had a very, very good work ethic. So growing up, going through school and eventually, working, he soared with everything he did. He was very healthy. My father is a marathon runner, and naturally providing that example for me and Alex kind of got into that as well. He ended up doing two marathons, several 10Ks, and even more 5Ks, which we did together a lot as a family. He also did two triathlons with me in 2010-2011. We used to do an annual race called Run for the Pies. It was in Jupiter, Florida. It was a Thanksgiving Day race. And we did it, many years in a row. And one year in 2013, Alex and myself and my father, we got in our car, as we usually did, and drove up to Jupiter, Florida from West Palm Beach. And we did our run. And me and my dad realized that something was off with Alex, with his breathing, with his run. He was usually a pretty strong runner. I usually was last. My father was usually first, and Alex usually came in a close second to my dad. But that day, Alex came in last out of the three of us, and we knew something was wrong, and Alex did too. And we told Alex, we want to make sure you're going to get that checked out. And he did. And a few months later, January of 2014, he was diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer.
That must have been shocking. I mean, he was a young, healthy guy and a non-smoker and, looked after himself. And what was that like for the family to find that out?
Honestly, it was just a bad dream. We thought we were all in a bad dream. It was a nightmare. It was very unexpected. This was happening to someone who ate well, who took care of himself, who really took fitness seriously. I mean, he wasn't a professional athlete, but, he wasn't necessarily weekend warrior only either. So hearing that news was really, really rough. And it was rough for us as a family because Alex was, in many ways, the leader of our family. He was very outspoken. We trusted him. So we knew that our roles in the family were going to change, that instead of him always taking care of us, we were going to have to take care of him. It was rough.
I understand that he did have genomic testing done. He had the EGFR mutation, which for someone coming to lung cancer discussion for the first time may not mean a whole lot, but is actually really important. Because it gave him some treatment options that that were targeted to that EGFR mutation. So in a sense, he was lucky to be able to have those targeted therapies to be able to rely on. Isn't that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. In the beginning, we were very confused. We didn't really know what to expect. We didn't know what hit us. And then we found out about this mutation, and that there was a targeted therapy for it. We didn't know anything about targeted therapy or chemo or, so everything was very new to us. So the beginning experience for us was actually, it was semi-comforting, if you can even use that term when it comes to lung cancer treatment, because we just found out, oh, okay, he just has to take a pill and there'll be minimal side effects and then he'll be okay. So yeah, he started off with Tarceva back in 2014, minimal side effects, and it really, he took to it very well. He was feeling better quite quickly and for a good amount of time.
Which is really lucky. Tell me about, so many people are coming to this story for the first time through This Is Us, which is just this incredible, amazing, very popular TV show. How, what was that relationship like? How did he end up being honored at the end of last week's episode?
So Alex, you know, born and raised in Brooklyn and, you know, had jobs in New York City doing ad sales, and had an opportunity to go out to the West Coast to accept a job, a position doing ad sales with Microsoft. This was based out of L.A. So when he first moved out to L.A., he had a couple of friends from New York, the East Coast, recommending a couple of their friends to hang out with on the West Coast. And one of those guys was Larry Stern. And Larry Stern had a friend named Dan Fogelman. And they just hit it off really quick. They became kind of like the Three Musketeers, Alex, Larry, and Dan. And they kind of formed a little bit of a brotherhood out there, because when you're out in L.A. with no family, all you have is each other. So they got really close. And Dan, along with Larry, of course, has become a very close family friend of ours.
And tell me about, you all have started the I Got This fund. Tell me more about, from the family perspective, you know, we talked about this the other day, that lung cancer affects so many people. It affects such a wide range of people. Tell me about what it is that you're doing going forward.
Yeah, so, you know, from I Got This, it went to We Got This. So we started up this fund called the We Got This Fund. And, you know, in its, you know, beginnings, it's basically been an organization to raise awareness, kind of to assist LCFA in what lung cancer is and isn't and who it really does affect, that you don't need to be a smoker to get lung cancer. And that also there is hope, there is treatment. So We Got This Fund basically, you know, focuses on that, but something that we're getting into now, which we want to focus more on in the future, is the social services aspect, how the family is affected, how it's not just about that one person, how it's not just I got this, it's we got this, it's family affected, it's friends, it's the person's business, coworkers, they're affected too. So we're going to be focusing on that when We Got This Fund moving forward. We're going to keep fitness at the heart of it, health at the heart of it, but also mental health, emotional health, because you can't take care of someone who is sick with cancer if you're not taking care of yourself.
What a wonderful, wonderful tribute to your brother. And we're so grateful for your support and for everything that you and We Got This is doing. And I'm grateful on a quiet Sunday morning that you had a few minutes to chat and tell us more about your brother.
Completely my pleasure. I know that everything that we do, just from the Haddon family and the We Got This Fund, it's Alex is behind us, smiling and pushing us. So, you know, that's what it's all about. It's all about the love.
Thank you so much. And if you'd like to learn more about Alex Haddon and other lung cancer heroes and more information about lung cancer treatments and different possibilities, please visit us at lcfamerica.org. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.